Good morning. I'm coming on this morning because I have something really important to talk about. Yesterday, I got on to share about how I had not, I had heard back from two more TEDx conferences and I did not get them, and the feelings of rejection that came up. And some very loving people commented saying, that's not failure. It just means just not yet. And while I really appreciate that sentiment, I just want to say that I think it's really dangerous and not okay to tell people that, I didn't hit a goal. I tried something and I didn't get it. That is the Webster definition of not hitting a failure. We as a society are really uncomfortable with the idea of hitting a goal. I didn't hit that goal, and it doesn't feel good to try and not get what you tried for getting. And it doesn't mean I'm bad. It doesn't mean I'm a failure, and I know that, but it is dangerous to tell someone that those feelings, that sadness, that's not failure, that's not legitimate. It was a failing. And I really think that if we are not able to pause and honor the lessons that failure have for us, we are missing the point. So I categorically disagree with anyone that says that trying something and not getting it is not a failure. That is absolutely a failure. It just isn't the end of my story. I have put in 15 applications. I've now heard back from 3. So for this year and this go around, it means that there's a lot more for me to hear back from. I don't have a timeline on when I'll hear back from any of them. That's not how TEDx works. And someone said, maybe you should try speaking at other places. Yeah, I do speak at other places. So it's not that I don't have practice. It's that the application process for a TEDx talk is very, very competitive. It is not the same thing as landing other talks. And an interesting piece about the TEDx journey is that when you're applying for TEDx, they don't tell you why you didn't get something. So there's no feedback. Some of them ask for past, like how you spoke in the past, examples of that, which I do have those and I can send them, and I have in those scenarios. But it's just a different process. But the main reason that I want to talk about this is because what's super dangerous is we see so many people and we just see their highlight reel, okay? So we just see like when they've landed the job, or when they've landed the client, or when they've had a successful launch, because all we're talking about is success. I wanna change the narrative, and I wanna show that it's okay to fail. It's okay to feel those feelings and be upset in those feelings and not dismiss them. Being that toxic positivity and ignoring the feelings that come does everyone a disservice. But being brave and sharing what's painful and what's hurtful, and where there's stumbling blocks, it helps normalize that the process is a roller coaster. It helps normalize for those other entrepreneurs that try something and hit something really great and then hit a setback and then hit something really great and then hit a setback. In entrepreneurship, in business building, like the high and the low in the course of one day is significant, okay? And it's not like a straight job where you go to work and even if you encounter a failure or a setback, that that is, like, you're still going to get paid in a straight job. But in my line of work, if you screw something up or if you don't get something, it's changing your stability trajectory. And so it's like, the more we can talk about these things, the more we can normalize them for each other, the more we can understand, like, what the process is. And, you know, for anybody that wants to be an entrepreneur, I want you to do it. And I want to be someone that shows you what that looks like in reality, not just the highlight reels, which is why I'm committed to this type of transparency and why I'm committed to calling things what they are. When you don't get it, that's failure. And, you know, I've had a friend recently go through some major challenges. And when they're going through those major challenges, you know, they've said things like, so-and-so made it look so easy. And I'm sure so-and-so had those types of setbacks too. But knowing that failure is a part of the process, that those setbacks, those things that are uncomfortable, those things that hurt, they are actually a part of what get us to success, is what's important. Like, it doesn't feel good, and that is the road to success. That is the road to getting there. It's not, you know, somebody said failure, like, you're just not getting there yet. No, I just failed, and this is what the process looks like. And the process is not rainbow. I'm not pooping rainbows. It doesn't feel good, but I'm gonna keep a positive attitude, and I'm gonna believe, if not this, something better is coming. And it is 100% about mindset. And you can have a good mindset and accept that you failed, that you didn't hit the goal. Those things are not mutually exclusive. So that's where I am. That's why I think this is so gosh darn important. And that's why I'm sharing this with all of you. That's why I'm sharing this journey and this story. But I would love to hear what your thoughts are based on what I just had to say. So hit me up, let me know. I want to hear from you. Talk to you soon.